Afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Worship on YouTube. Happy Independence Day weekend. It is July the 5th and the day after July the 4th. And so I would like to begin in prayer as we normally do, but I also just want to, in our prayer, pray for our country on this special weekend. So would you pray with me as we begin? Lord, thank you for this day, and we thank you for your love and your mercy. We praise you. You are awesome and mighty and great and worthy to be praised. We thank you also, Lord, for the country that we live in. We know that it is not perfect by any means. There is no country that is. And we look toward your kingdom, which is perfect, and we look forward to the day we get to fully be a part of that. But while we're here, Lord, we pray for our country, that you would give wisdom to our leaders, that you would protect us, and that you would help us to glorify you. We pray that you would be with all people in our country, that there would be justice and equality and peace for all. And it's in your name we pray. Amen. Well, let us worship the Lord this July the 5th. And we'll have a song, and then we'll have a message. And we'll have a closing song and closing prayer after that. So let's worship the Lord.
Up and sing of the great and glorious King. You are strong, you feel weak, in your brokenness complete. Shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all. Rise up, women of the truth. Stand and sing to broken hearts. Who can know the healing power of our awesome King of love? Shout to the north and the south. Sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all. Sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth. We've been through fire, we've been through rain. We've been revived by the power of His name. We've fallen deeper in love with you. You burn the truth on our lips. To the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth. We will shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven. Church with broken wings, fill this place with songs again of our God who reigns on high. By His grace again we'll fly. And shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth. Yeah, shout to the north.
Amen. Well, today, y'all, today, this week, we are finishing our sermon series on the book of Exodus and on God being in the rescuing business. This is the last message in this story. And so it's exciting, and it's exciting that we went all the way through it. And it's a good end to the story. But of course, it's Independence Day here in the United States, so I want to start there. Independence Day, July 4th, 1776, is when the Declaration of Independence was signed. It is when our country was born. So this is our country's birthday. So we are celebrating independence from England. We are celebrating our nation's birth. And what is interesting is that in our Bible passage today, the Israelites celebrate their Independence Day, right? Because they have been in slavery in Egypt for 400 years, and they have finally escaped from Egypt, and they are celebrating their Independence Day in Exodus 15, which we're going to look at today. It's their Independence Day, so it matches up perfectly with what we're celebrating this weekend. And the thing that we can all celebrate together, no matter what country we are from or what country we live in, is that we can praise God who rescues us. That's how this story ends. That's what the Israelites do. They praise God who rescues us. And that's true for us. We are to praise God who rescues us. So that's what we're going to look at today. What does that mean, and how do we do that? But let's just review what we've gone over in this series. All right, so we've seen that God is in the rescuing business. We see that all the way through. You remember way back at the beginning, Pharaoh was going to kill all the Israelite baby boys, but God rescued them. He used a couple of Israelite midwives who saved the babies, and so God rescued the babies. Then God had this boy Moses born, and he saved Moses from being killed by having him adopted into Pharaoh's family. So God rescues Moses, and then Moses grows up and he has to run away from Egypt, but God stays with the Israelites still, and he's committed to rescuing them. And eventually Moses encounters God at the burning bush. You remember that? And God says, I am who I am. I am going to rescue the Israelites. And he sends Moses back to rescue the Israelites. And Moses confronts Pharaoh along with his brother Aaron. And God, through Moses and Aaron, sends 10 plagues upon Egypt. Hail, livestock passing away, frogs, gnats, locusts, flies, all of these crazy things. God sends them on Egypt, and eventually, finally, Pharaoh decides to let the Israelites go. So the Israelites leave Egypt, but then Pharaoh at the last minute changes his mind, chases after them, tries to get them, but God defeats the entire Egyptian army and rescues his people from Egypt once and for all. And they get through the Red Sea. Remember, God opens up the Red Sea and Israel passes right through it. They get to the other end. God closes the Red Sea. And that's where we left off last week. Today is different than the rest of the messages in this series, because this has been an adventure. This has been full of danger, and God has to rescue the Israelites over and over. Today, there's no danger. It's all celebration. They have made it. God has rescued them, and they are going to praise God who rescues us. And so today is all about celebration.
It's a celebration. Celebrate good times. Come on. Let's celebrate.
Okay, so when I think of celebration, I often think about music. And what happens in Exodus 15 is that Moses and the Israelites sing to God. They sing, they celebrate, they praise God who's rescued them. And it's awesome. And so Exodus 15 is basically the lyrics to the song that they sing. So I'm going to read just a little bit of those lyrics. What did they sing to God? Well, we don't know the tune. We don't know what the song sounded like, but we have the lyrics here in Exodus 15. So I'm going to read verses 1 to 6 and then verse 11. So here is just some of what the Israelites sang to God. They were praising him who had rescued them. It says, "Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. They sang, 'I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The horse and its rider he has hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a warrior. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his army he has hurled into the sea. The best of Pharaoh's officers are drowned in the Red Sea. The deep waters have covered them. They sank to the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, was majestic in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shattered the enemy. Who among the gods is like you, O Lord? Who is like you? Majestic in holiness, awesome in glory, working wonders.'" That's some pretty powerful lyrics. I bet the song sounded good too. Who knows? Do you think Moses was a good singer? I don't know. It'd be interesting to hear what Moses' singing voice is like. But what they are singing to God is that, "God, you are awesome. We praise you. We rely on you. You have rescued us from this terrible army, and you are great. You are majestic. You are holy." All of these amazing words. And they praise God, and they celebrate by praising God. And notice they also talk about God as a strong warrior. And sometimes we think about Jesus as like this like little gentle, wouldn't harm a fly, which is true, but kind of weak person. But no, God is strong and he is a warrior. So you can think about whatever you're facing right now, any difficulty, any hardship, anything that's an obstacle, anything that's coming up against you, any bad thing, God is a warrior. And when we trust in him and serve him, he will fight for us. He will protect us because he is strong and he's a warrior. He defeated the entire Egyptian army. He's so strong. And that is the God we serve. The other thing, and the last thing I'm going to point out, is that God doesn't just rescue us for nothing, right? He doesn't just take us away from bad things. He brings us to good things. So he doesn't just rescue Israel from slavery and then they're just abandoned. No, they're celebrating because they know that God is leading them to the promised land, to this really great place where they're going to be prosperous and they're going to have good times and they're going to be safe and it's going to be great. God rescues us too from hard times and bad things, not just so that we can get back to like boring life, but so that we can have joy and peace and love and safety and just all of this time for celebration and praising God. That's what heaven is. That's what life with God is like. When we trust Him and follow Him, life is amazing. Doesn't mean everything goes perfectly. Doesn't mean everything goes well, but God is so great and good that it makes life pretty good. So we praise God who rescues us. So He rescued Israel from Egypt, clearly. What does He rescue us from? Why should we praise God if we're to praise God for rescuing us? What has He rescued us from? Well, I think about it. God has rescued me literally from death. There have been a couple times when I've been in a car in an accident where I could have died, but God rescued me from that. There have been a few times where I've been sick or injured that could have gotten really worse, but God rescued me from that. There have been times where I could have been in poverty. I could have been not having a home. I could have been going hungry, but God rescued me from that by providing for me. All kinds of things, but ultimately, God rescues us from the worst things, from sin and from death. He rescues us from those things, and He gives us eternal life through His Son, Jesus Christ, and His death and resurrection. God rescues us from sin and death, and He gives us eternal life. He gives us the promise of heaven. He gives us relationship with Him. So we don't have to be going around ashamed our whole life of the bad things we've done, because God forgives us and He's rescued us from our sin. And we don't have to go around afraid of death, because God will rescue us from that and give us eternal life after death. So we can celebrate. And when I think of celebration, one of the things I think about is this clip right here.
So Vernon Maxwell, 6 of 7 from the line, make a 7 of 8, 21 points. Rockets again by 6. Time running out on the New York Knicks. The Houston Rockets are the 1993-94 NBA champions.
It's celebration. God has won the victory. He has defeated the enemy. He defeated Pharaoh. He's defeated the devil on our behalf. He is the champion. He has won. Praise God who rescues us. So we celebrate and worship Him and praise Him. So let's finish this worship service on this Independence Day by worshiping God and praising God who rescues us in song, just like the Israelites. praise God who rescues us. God is in the rescuing business. Remember that. So we have finished our series on the Exodus. Next week, well, and we'll talk a little bit more about it one last time this Wednesday during Bible Party online. So check that out this Wednesday night at 7 p.m. But next week, we begin a new series on the book of Ruth. Ruth is one of the best stories in the Bible. So look forward to that. I would like to close in prayer for now. And let's close in prayer. Lord, we thank you that you are in the rescuing business. And we do praise you for you rescue us. You rescue us from bad things all the time, even without us realizing it often. And you offer us rescue from sin and death through your Son, Jesus. And so we trust in him and we follow him. And it's in him that we put our faith. We again thank you for this Independence Day weekend. And we pray that you would be with us this coming week. We love you and we praise you. Amen. Happy Independence Day one more time. Y'all have a great week and God bless.